Hello everybody, in this lecture I will be solving 2017 IMO problem number 4. Here is a view of this problem and a simple sketch as well. So we are given two points R and S on circle omega. Here are these points R and S. We are also told to draw the tangent line to the circle omega at the point R, and we label it as L, like here. Next, we construct the point T such that RS is equal to ST. So T is on ray RS beyond S, such that RS is equal to ST. Next, we randomly pick a point J on the minor arc of RS on circle omega. And then we are ready to draw the circumcircle of TSJ. And that's the green, that's the red circle, which I labeled as gamma as well, as stated in the problem clearly. And finally, this red circle is supposed to hit the tangent line L at a point A and another point, but A is the closer one to the point R, and so that's the one that we need. Finally, we would like to label the extension of the intersection of AJ, ray AJ, with the circle omega as K. And finally, the problem is to find, is to show that KT, this line that I have already drawn, is tangent to the red circle at T. Okay, so to begin with, I would like to make the following claim that RK is in fact parallel to AT. So let me draw RK and then AT as well, so probably something like that. And I claim that those two lines are parallel, so for that I will be chasing some angles. Let's start with angle ATS. Angle ATS, I claim, is equal to 180 degrees minus angle SJA, because, and so we have this line, let me connect this line as well, because TSJA is on circle gamma, so this is a cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles are supplementary, and as a result, ATS, of course, is equal to 180 minus SJA, but then this is in turn equal to SJK, angle SJK. So therefore, this angle here is basically equal to that angle. But finally, angle SJK subtends on omega on circle omega, subtends our minor arc KS. But that arc is also subtended by angle SRK, which in turn is equal to angle TRK, TRK. So finally, what we have done is to show that two angles here are alternate interior angles, and as such it shows that these two lines are actually parallel. My next idea would be noticing that S is the midpoint of RT, and between these two parallel lines we can consider constructing, I should say, a parallelogram RAT. Call the remaining point as say a P. So if I had to extend this line RK and also draw a parallel to the line L, so that would meet at this point P. So I did draw, all I did was to draw TP and extend RK to P, such that we have now construct parallelogram RATP, which we did. So once this is constructed, it is clear that RST is a diagonal of this parallelogram, as is ASP. So therefore, this shows that ASP are collinear, ASP collinear, simply by this parallelogram construction. So let me go ahead and draw that line as well. So probably I will use a different color, ASP, and obviously S is the midpoint of AP as well. And next, I would like to continue to the angle chasing, and in fact, let me extend this line, draw the line segment KS. You can notice that angle SKR, let me continue here, angle SKR is in fact, so if you check this angle here, of course it subtends minor arc RS, but that arc is also subtended by this tangency angle here. So therefore, this is equal to SRA, angle SRA. But of course, T, S, and R are collinear, so therefore this angle is also equal to TRA. But notice that TRA is simply equal to PTA because of the parallelogram, right? So this is simply equal to angle PTA. These are alternate interior angles given that PT and RA are parallel lines. But this is beautiful because we have just established that SKR, which is 180 minus PKS, is equal to PTS, suggesting that, so this would therefore imply that quadrilateral PKST is cyclic. And now we are ready to complete the proof. We were to show that KT is tangent to the red circle at the point T. For that, all I need to do is to show that KTS is equal to SAT. But this is immediate because consider these angles. So if I start with the angle KTS and this red angle here, angle KTS is simply equal to angle KPS, because both angles subtend arc KS in that new circle, so that's equal to KPS. But KPS in turn is equal to KPA obviously, but because it's a transversal on the parallel lines RP and AT, so therefore by alternate interior angles that should simply be equal to PAT, or simply SAT, angle SAT, and boom, and that obviously proves the result because we were able to represent the minor arc ST with SAT, but at the same time this being equal to KTS immediately implies that in fact KT is tangent to gamma at T. And that solves this problem. Hope you enjoyed it and looking forward to see you guys in our next lecture.